excuse the fact that I'm whispering. It's hella early here and I've got sleeping babies. Look, it's just gonna be stuck with me this time around. I wonder where you're going. Stay tuned for more. Don't know, now you know I am in Melbourne. Gosh, it feels so weird to be talking to a phone camera, but such is life, what we do for our Matuvale. So I'm here. I hope that you've liked the scenery so far, and I'll be taking you with me as we explore a little bit and meet some loved ones and family. So for those who don't know, I actually grew up in Melbourne. So Melbourne's sort of like my hometown. But my husband and I relocated to Sydney after we had our first two children. And but Melbourne will always be home, always, always be home. So stay with me and I hope you enjoy the ride. Okay, so I hope you guys can hear me, LT family. I am now in downtown Melbourne. I am actually on the corner of Bourke Street and Swanston Street. And if for anyone who watched my husband tag with my darling, you guys would have known that our first date was actually on this corner. Not on this corner like where I'm standing at, but at a cinema joint that has actually closed down now. 16 years later. I am going to literally hang out by myself for about an hour or so before I meet up with a girlfriend, a very close friend of mine, and actually just to show those overseas how close it is, where I am actually at in on that corner just down there is where the terrorist attack that happened here in Melbourne. So sad, you know, having grown up here and knowing that this is something that happened sort of, you know, in our own backyard. I think for us, we're very accustomed to it happening elsewhere. And then when it sort of happens here, it's like too real. So anyways, I'm gonna get off this shot right now because I feel like people are watching me because I look weird. Lol. And hopefully the next time you see me, I'll be eating something and you won't be looking at my forehead. Bye. Just casually walking. And they have an open area here to see them make dumplings. And this is on Shanghai Street. There you go.
Fresh dumplings for ya.
Hey LT family, so I am at the spot that I'm going to be eating at today. I actually waited till they opened and I'm actually their first customer for the day. And I actually found this place through Food Tales. So for anyone who doesn't know, these are two sisters that have their own mukbang channel. And I will put their link down below of them eating this particular dish. And it is amazing. Like kusima is like an understatement. So I will be ordering at least one of their dishes because they had three, but I'm gonna be ordering one. And yeah, it's going to be amazing. I cannot wait. So like you all know that I'm actually like you all know what a freaking fresh anyways I am here in Melbourne City with my girl Mrs. SA. She is also a baker, a t-shirt maker, a everything right here all rolled into one. And she was I have to admit she actually is very instrumental in me as a new time wifey. She taught me a lot. So she's here on her lunch break. She's giving me her time. And we're having the much anticipated rice. Oh, well, she's having sushi because she doesn't eat prawns. I just came to know. And prawns. Yep. So this is prawn tower and there's three of them. I'm not going to eat it on camera because I need to like finger lick and need to get into this. And our time is very precious. So we love you and I'll get back to you the review. Don't mind my gut and all because we're sitting on the grass, okay? Peace out.
Bye.
Oh my gosh, those prawns were honestly to die for. I am now at Flinders Street Station. Yes. And I'm making my way down to Dandenong on the Pakenham or Cranbourne line. Still got a few more important people to see. And yeah, just so thankful to like just be here and have this time away.
I love my life.
Hey LT family. So it has been such an exhausting day. It's probably like after almost 3 o'clock here and the weather is great and my lips are looking a lot better, lol. Okay, so if you guys have noticed, I've already seen one of my closest girlfriends. I'm still yet to see a lot of people, but one of the most important person that I have come to see as well is my Padre. Everyone who doesn't know, my dad is actually based in Melbourne, and yeah, so we're here. So dad, say hi to the family.
Sandra.
So that is my dad and he is from
Kurutumbura.
And so why do the people from Ra actually say Yandra all the time, all day, anytime, blah blah blah? They say Yandra evening, morning, midday. Why?
Well, because Lutunosomo was married to an Egyptian woman. An Egyptian, the meaning of Ra, the meaning of Ra is the sunrise. That's in Egyptian language, I believe, if I'm right.
Right. Yeah.
So that's why.
So why do they say Yandra?
Well, to us, it's like good days in Australia. It's similar to that. Everything is good. Sayandra. So you are alive. You are still alive. Like good Bula. Bula is the meaning of Bula is alive. Or Bula Vinaka. Have a good life. So Sayandra is, you must be awake all the time.
And that is why we say Yandra all the time. So right now we are actually in Dandenong City, downtown Dandenong. For those that know Dandenong, for those that don't, we're at downtown Dandenong. We just had a salad, something to eat. I feel like I've been eating this whole time. My dad's been giving me slack about my weight, but meanwhile. And so till I see the next person that will pop up in my vlog. And until then, I was actually supposed to vlog a little bit of my ride here because the train stations, for those who have been in Melbourne for a while, it's actually changed a lot, but I fell asleep because your girl has been awake since 3:30 this morning. But I'll try and see if I can get a train ride and then take some more clips on the train. But if not, till the next person. Dad, say goodbye.
No, I can't say goodbye. I said hello and have a good day.
Okay, have a good day.
Jesus bless.
Yes.
Jesus bless. Always believe in praying. Always believe in doing good things to other people, because that's the most important thing in life. Jesus came to serve. His last supper, he broke the bread. He was the one that was serving the disciple. He poured the wine. He was the one that doing that. So I believe, whether you are a minister or whatever position you are in, you must learn to serve the people, because that's why you have been created as a human being. You become God's image.
Thanks, Dad.
And Jesus bless you and bless all of us and bless all our families all over the world. Different colors of skin, different language, different culture, different beliefs.
That
everyone knows that his name is called Jesus, that there is no other name given under heaven and earth that people will be saved, but in the name of Jesus.
Thanks, Dad. And that is my dad for you. So, till the next time, I will be on here in probably the next hour.
Okay, let me finish it today.
Peace.
No.
Dad, this is only just like a 10-minute vlog, and my dad's.
No, it's important to me.
It is important.
Because it's important to me. This is the first time I've been given a privilege.
Dad,
to speak like this. So
I just charged my phone, Dad.
No.
Okay, love you, Dad.
No. To me, it's cool.
Dad, say bye. Bye.
It is Saturday, and I am at a wedding family gathering. Have a look at my food. You're welcome. So I'm gonna live my life today.
I'm gonna live my life today. So everybody else is singing. Family! So I'm out here vlogging, cause in Melbourne it is Saturday, and this is your girl. There you go. So I'm here with my sisters that I've grown up with, and we're just out here being all natural and all country. And then here we go.
Hi.
Here's all the amazing girl, and this is in her natural habitat. This is Metro Girls, for those who that don't know. So anyways, we had a wedding today, and we're no one really believes that we're in the country, but we really literally are in the country. In what is this? In Dandenong country, which is really not country, but country. And we had a great day celebrating love today for people that we truly love and appreciate. And it's now, for those of you who saw my food, it was crazy good, and there's still so much left. And for those who cannot see my makeup, I had my makeup done. I'm loving this. I feel like I keep having my makeup done for like the last month. And we're out here like all natural and ourselves and photos and selfies. But yeah, it is Saturday. It is like after 3, and we still have plenty of day left and plenty of night left. To do, and probably lots of food and dessert. And for anyone who doesn't know, I think last week two vlogs ago, I did a mention of a baker by the name of Lorna Love, and this is her. Yours truly. This is her, and she killed it today. She killed it today with a 3-tier cake. And actually, we'll probably get a word with her later, but she literally is self-taught, home baker, and she whipped up something last night while me and Navy girl Miss Funny. We were killing it. We were literally killing it, having everything and anything that we tasted. Oh, tasted very happily. I mean, that's an actual job. But that is the face and the front of the face, the forefront, the whatnot of Lorna Love. She did so good today. She sang today. Her voice sounds like the voice of an angel. For those who haven't heard her yet, my belt is just like. So So yeah, so I will come back to you with some dessert, hopefully some wedding cake, and yeah, we're just gonna chill. It's literally nearly the end of my holiday and I can't wait to get back to my babies. Peace out.
Okay, no, sorry.
Snippet in regards to like just final thoughts of Melbourne altogether. Okay, so I obviously haven't been back to Melbourne in a year or just over a year, and it was just great to be able to go back and reconnect. It was a weekend of new beginnings, it was a weekend of forgiveness, it was a weekend of growth, of lots of laughter and I would say revelations, whether it be for them or for myself. I also learned that time is a healer of all things, but to probably speed up sometimes the process of maybe hurt or whatever, it's great to communicate. So communication is definitely a must, and understanding is a must, to not just communicate to answer back, but to communicate to actually listen and take it in. I also realized that assumptions is a killer of everything. I realized that my dad is getting older and I should appreciate him and make more time for him, whether it be a visit like that or whether it just be to actually talk, because he generally does call me like every day or every second day to speak to the kids, but not to actually talk. I realized that friendships that I might have held to high regard before probably isn't so much of a priority anymore, and that friendships that I probably pushed to the side mean a lot more to me, and that it weekends like this for mothers, and whether it be for mothers or couples or husbands, is needed. It's a great sort of a refresher. You recharge the battery a little bit and come back to what matters most. And obviously my life at the end of the day is, and what is more important to me is being a wife and being a mother at the end of the day. So I hope that you enjoy this little snippet of a little sort of weekend vlog that I did. Sorry if some of the scenes don't mesh up, but you know, it was fun. It was a good weekend. So I thank you. We thank you to all the new subbies. Welcome to our Matu Vale that have been following us. Thank you for being so loyal to us. And also to those that don't know our girl Sarah, we mentioned her I think in this first vlog maybe, or the second. She started off as a writer, and now she actually has her own channel. So we're gonna put the link of her channel down below. please support her, because she has some knowledge, and she has it with a girl by the name of Arieta. So it's their channel together, Real Talk. So yeah, please follow, show them some love, let them know that you came from us, if you did. But you know, I'm sure that we're excited to see their show as it progresses as well. So yeah, to the rest of you all, have a great week. And to my girls, Dylan and Tim, I'll see you in the next upload. Love you guys.